Welcome to this channel. Today I will teach you how to make this blouse. It's a blouse with a lace pattern attached to it. I'll teach you how to make it. I would like you to watch to the very end if you really want to know how to do this design, especially how to attach the pattern to it, attach the legs. So it has a ruffle, a flare ruffle at the bottom. So let's get started. But before I start, if today is your first time to this channel, I would like you to subscribe to this channel, like this video, share this video, leave your comment at the comment section.
I'll be carving it out on the paper before applying on the fabric. So without wasting time, I'll be working with the hip measurement, the blouse part first before the skirt, and I'll be using the shoulder, the waistline, because it's going to have a flare off at the end. So let's get started. First of all, I'll be getting the length from shoulder to the waistline. It's 13 inches because it's for a little girl. 13 inches. Your own can be any length. 1 inch plus her 1 inch seam allowance. 1 inch seam allowance. Like this. We are talking of 13 inches for the waist and 1 inch seam allowance. Like this. And mark it out. You mark it out. Like this. This is from shoulder to the length. From shoulder to the waistline. Then you get the shoulder length. That is, the shoulder is 13 inches. That is 6.5 inches divided by 2, 6.5 inches. Mark it here. From here you get the armhole. The armhole will be 6 inches for the girl. 6 inches. 6 inches is here. Then you draw a line. Draw a bow. This is the waist line, the waist. Then the waist is 33. That is 24. 24 divided by 4 is 6 inches. 6 inches. 6 inches will come here. Then from 1 inch seam allowance. Here. So we are going to draw a line to meet with this. Okay, the bust is 26. 26 divided by 3, by 4 is 6.5 inches. So we are going to get our 6.5 inches. 6.5 inches is here, plus 1 inch seam allowance. It's here. Then you draw a line. Then you'll be getting the neckline. I'm using 2.5 inches. This is 2.5 inches by 3 inches. Like this. You draw a line to meet it. So you don't forget to give a slight, because her shoulder is not straight. You slice it by half inch. Then you make a cut. Remember, this is the main length. You will be adding 1/2 inch or 1 inch or 2 inches depending on the type of fabric you are using. I'm using a kind of stretchy fabric, so I decided to make it 1 inch, same allowance. At this point, I'll be cutting it out. At this point, I'll be getting 4 inch from the up. I'll be getting 4 inch from up, from this end, from the shoulder. I'll be getting 4 inch because I'll be adding legs to the up. 4 inch. I'm using this as a guide. Okay, let's use as a guide because it has been. Four inches. And you're going to draw a line. We're cutting it out. We're using this to cut the left side, and this the fabric. So this is what you'll get. I've already cut it. This will go for the fabric, and this is for the lace. So without wasting much of our time, I'll be placing this on the fabric, the blue part. I make it the blue. I'll be placing this on the fabric, cutting it out. I'm placing this on the lace, cutting it out. You'll see how I do it. This is the front side. Then I've properly placed it, and I'll be cutting it out. This is it. How it will look like. Then be using this to cut out this. So you'll be placing it. Look at it. Remember to put 1 inch. Same allowance. Supposed to add on the other one 1/2 inch, but since I did not have, I decided to put 1 inch here. So this is what you will get. This is the up, the left side. That's exactly what you'll get. So let's get the back. So I'll be using this paper. I'll be cutting out, because the front and the back side, the neckline will not be the same. So I'll be adding 2 inch, I'll be leaving 2 inch, 1/2 inch at the back. The back will be up, then it's the front that will be deep. Half inch. okay, this is what you get. This is what you get. This is for the back side. Remember, this is the front side. This is the front side. And this is the back side. You'll do the same. But to simplify it, you place this on top of this. Sorry. Place it on top of this. Just to get the same measurement you get for the back. Then you cut. Then you place this on your fabric. Remember, you fold your fabric into two bezel blocks. So, one. You first go first into fold into two before placing your fabric on it. Then, at this point, you cut it out. You can use scissors pin to hold it. Or you can as well cut it. So, you fold your fabric. Cutting the back side, fold your fabric into two bezel blocks. This should be serving as the back side. Fold your fabric into two bezel blocks. Then leave 1 inch seam allowance for the zipper, depending on what you want. But for the sake of this tutorial, I'll be leaving 1 inch. Position your paper, your pattern well. You can use pin to hold it. You can as well cut it if you are sure. You will be able to hold it well. I'm cutting the back side of it. I did exactly what I did in the other side, leaving 1 inch seam allowance for zipper. So you do this. Remember to cut it out. And notch it. So that you know where the zip allowance starts. This is what you get. And when you put the zip, it will come together. You will see how it will be. Just repeat what you did in the front side. Cut at leaving 1 inch allowance for seam. Just cut it out. Remember to put 2 inches. Half inch, sorry, for the zip allowance as you add in the other side.
is what you get. When you cut it, you get this. Then don't forget to slit. And notch to know where the 2½ inch for the zipper starts, and cut it. So this is it. This is for up. This is for the back panel. This is the back panel. This is how it will go. And you see how it will look when I'm through sewing it. Okay. At this point, we'll be cutting the ruffle. To cut the ruffle, you fold your fabric. You know how to cut circular. Circular gown, circular top, circular everything. So you fold your fabric this way. Then you fold it again. You get something like this as a triangle. Then you mark, use the waist 24 divided by 4 will give you 6 inches. This is the 6 inch. This is a 6 inch. Yeah, the final length is 18 inches. You are going to, you have gotten 14. You have gotten 14 inches. You are minusing 14. From 14, you get to get 18 inches plus 1 inch seam allowance. This 18 inches, then 1 inch seam allowance. This is the simplest way to get this. You minus your waistline. Then, from there, you get the normal measurement. Understand what you are doing. Minus your upper bust to waist inches, your waistline measurement, then arrive at the normal measurement. But this one is the 19 inches. Then I'll be cutting it. So this is how it will look. This is how it will look like. So to make sure it's equal, you do this. I mean the bottom side, to make sure this side is equal, you do this. It's equal. No side is bigger than this side. So this is what I have for you. If this video has helped you in any way, I would like you to share this video. Give it a thumbs up. Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to this channel if you have not done so. Leave your comment at the comment section. Bye bye. I will show you how I sew it. I will show you how I sew it. If you have not subscribed, subscribe. Subscribe now, subscribe.
Okay, to make, this is the, all the panels. This is the back panel. I leave 2 inches, half inch. I leave half inch seam allowance for the zipper, properly notch. This is back panel. This is the flare ruffle. This is the lace. Then at this point, I'll be starting with the front panel. I'll first pin it with the lace. I'll pin it to the this one. Use the right side to the right side, pin together. So this is what you get. I've properly pinned it. So this, remember, it's going to be the right side to the right side. So yes. I'll make a stitch.
So this is how it will
see the results.
I've already made a stitch. I've made a stitch on it. Make a stitch. Then this is the right side. This is how it will look like. Then next, I'll be attaching this. We're attaching this to it. Then I'll be attaching this to it. Then I will pin it. I decided to pin it in the middle, because I'll be sewing the both sides. I'll be sewing here and here. Like this. Then I'll make a stitch. I'll stitch here and I'll stitch here. I will show you how it will look like in a moment. So I've properly attached it to it. So I'm a kind of through with this for now. I'll be working with the back panel. This is the back panel, and I'll be doing same to it, placing. This is the right side. Then this is the right side of this one. And I'll be pressing it together like this. And I'll pin. Remember, there's a seam allowance. You put seam allowance for zipper. So you consider it. I notch it. You notch your own when doing it. When sewing, make sure you notch your own. I'm done pinning it to this. Then I'm going to make a stitch all the way. I'm going to make a stitch. You see how it will look like. This is the back panel. I've properly attached the net to it. I've attached the net to it and the lace to it. So this is what you get. I'll be doing same to it. I'll be attaching this like this using my pin to hold it. I'm holding it in the middle because I'm sewing both sides like this. So this is how it will be.
At this point, I'll be attaching the, I'll be joining the bow together. Then, I'll be attaching the zipper. So I'll be placing it like this. The wrong side to the right side to right side. Then I'll make a stitch, allowing 1 inch seam allowance as I leave it from the beginning when I was cutting it. Allow to 1 inch seam allowance. So I'll be considering that 1 inch. The 1 inch starts here. Then I put the zipper. This is it. You will see how it is. And I've attached the zipper. You see, I've attached the zipper. So I'll be adding. At this point, I'll be joining the front panel and the back panel together. I'll be joining the back panel and the front panel together. So what I'll be doing is this. I'll be using my needle as usual to pin. And it's at least 1/2 inch. Then you make a stitch. You join. Make a stitch. You see how it will look like. I've attached the shoulder. This is how it will look like. Then at this point I'll be making a stitch to the both side. I'll be joining this side. First of all, let me attach the sleeve. I want to attach the sleeve first. After attaching the sleeve, I'll join the both sides. At this point, I've attached the sleeve. So I've attached the sleeve. Now, I will be sewing the, closing the two sides. Then what I will do is to use the needle to hold it. 1/1 inch from the both side. Then I'll make a stitch. And I've used my pin to hold it. I'm going to make a stitch like this, then like this. You'll see how it will look in a moment. I've made a stitch. I'll be turning it over to the right side. So at this point, I'll be attaching the, this is how to look like, I'll be attaching the ruffles. The flare ruffles at the bottom. The flare is starting from the waist line. So what I will do is, this. I'll cut it open. As you can see, there is no joining, there is no opening. Then I'll open it up. Then I'll hold it like this. I'll open up the zipper. This is the
right side, and this is the right side. I'll be touching it this way. This is what you do. Use your pin to hold it first before making a stitch. You go around, you attach it to it first. So I properly attached it. So I'm going to make a stitch now. You see how it will look like. After stitching to it, then I will close up the zipper. You see how it will look like in a moment. So this is it. I'm through attaching it to the ruffles. Attach the ruffles. I'll finish it up. So this is how it will look. All you need to do just to hem the neckline and hem the down, hem the sleeve. So at this point, I know you have learned something from this tutorial. If this video has helped you in any way, I would like you to give this video a thumbs up, and I also want you to share it to so that your friend will see. Subscribe if you have not done so, and leave your comments at the comment section. Bye.